Good morning, Stampers. This is Diane Cisneros with Diane Will Teach Me That. Today I'm going to teach you how to make the muslin bags that I had posted earlier. I made 10 bags and 10 cards and gave them to someone as a gift to use in their business. And I'm going to show you a little trick I learned. You may already know, but I had to use my brayer. I didn't have to, but I found that it was much easier. The stamp set I'm going to use is Bordering Blooms, and I'm using this stamp right here. It's a photopolymer stamp, and I already have it on my block. And I'm going to take my early espresso, and I really saturated it yesterday with my refill, but if you haven't done that, you really need to get a lot of ink on here. And what I'm going to do, I've got my muslin bag and I've ironed it so it's nice and flat. Then I have taken a piece of cardboard and I cut it. Let's see. It's 3 1/4 this way. And I made it a little longer so I could pull it out by 6. And what we're going to do is just stick that in there to give us something solid, so it won't leak through all the way down to the bottom. Want it nice and flat on both sides. Okay, so I'm going to take, I tried stamping it like this by just putting a lot of ink on it and doing it this way. And then I found if I got ink on the edge or if I got it on the block, it ends up on the material. The material is different than paper. It is, it just absorbs everything around it. So I tried this and I found that it's a lot better. And again, this is probably, you only need to do this if you're using material. So I've got a lot of ink on here and this is early espresso. I'm going to go down the middle and back. I'm going to use the side and I'm going to use this side. I want to use all the ink on this roller. Okay, and I'm a little nervous because I'm on camera, so let's do it again. I want to make sure I'm saturated here. Okay, so then I'm going to take it, oh, geez, go down on the bottom, and in this case, you're going to rock this stamp. You go ahead and rock it and roll it, push it and press it, which is a lot more than what you would do with paper. And it's still not dark enough. Okay, so it's not as dark as I got it yesterday. So let me put a little more ink on my pad here. I'm going to roll it in. This prevents me from getting ink on the edges. Okay, so I'm going to try it again. And I'm going to do it again right there. You push it extremely hard, as hard as you can push it and rock it, because that material is porous and that's better. Okay, we're going to turn it over and do it again until we get it nice and dark. So, let me push one way with the whatever this is. The more ink you have on it, the better it's going to come out. We're trying to get a nice solid. Okay. Now, when I started doing this, okay, that's better, much better. I got it going so that I went right through the tent. The only bag I messed up was the first one, and I got 4 chances to practice on that one. And then from then on, I did okay. So this is kind of a practice thing. There, much better. Okay. So you can see. Now I'm going to show you what I did, what I'm going to do to cover up that little empty spot there. Okay, now I'm going to pull this out. And now I'm going to use the petite petals. I'm going to make a little flower. And here's the little punch. And I already had one left over from doing those yesterday, so I saved it for my video. I cut out three flowers. First, I stamped them. You can see that they're stamped. Then I punched them. Then I put them all together and put a brad through it. And then I was thinking, oh God, I got to get my heat gun out. It's might be a mess, and oh, it's too bad I have to do that. And I was just whining. And then I thought, oh, I know what I'll do. So this is the section right here that is not as dark as the rest. So I'm just going to take my paper piercer and make a hole. Put my brad right through the hole. Turn it inside out. Open those prongs. And OMG. Magic. So this, I'm going to pull these petals forward. I curled them a little bit when I put it together. But it's very secure now that I put it in the material. No glue gun. Oh, oh, oh. I'm just all about myself here. I guess after you've been doing this a while, things just come to you. Okay, so now I have a cute little flower there. And the next thing I'm going to do is take this cotton ribbon. This is Early Espresso, 1/4 inch cotton ribbon. And of course, of course, of course, I don't have scissors. Can you believe this? Okay, hang on. Hang on. Oh my God. Don't tell any of the professionals that I did that. They frown upon it. What, didn't have my scissors with me. Okay, so I do not tie a knot when I make my bows. I just make a loop. Oh, I'm shaking. I'm so nervous. Shouldn't have to go run after the scissors. Okay. Go over, pull it through, and make a bow. Now, of course, that's a little too big, so I'm going to pull my strings in. Pull this out a little bit so they match. Okay. And I want these a little bit long. So then I have another little thing I have to do. I've got my little thank you stamp from Lots of Thanks. It's right here. Thank you so much. And I'm going to take Early Espresso, stamp it right there. I'm going to punch it out with the 1 3/8. Oh my God, this video is 15 minutes long already. Okay, then I'm going to take this punch. I think it's available in the catalog now, but I've had this for years. You see the size of it? I'll have to get that for you and put it on. Just going to punch a hole in the top. Then I have some trinkets, antique trinkets, which include little safety pins that are antique. I'm going to put it through the back of, good Lord, back of the ribbon. And then into, I want that to stand up, and into that hole on the thank you. Oh. And then into the bag. I go in where the track is for the little rope. Okay. So there's thank you. My strings are just a hair long, so I'm gonna do that, and then okay, I'm away from my table again. And I'm gonna put some candy in here. I got some Ghirardelli chocolates. I'm gonna put three of those in. And then the Ferrero Rocher, those are good candies. Okay, so now we have a bag of candy, and I'm going to tighten these strings so that it puckers up a little. Tie it. And I didn't want to put the bow or anything on this because this is where you're going to open it to get the candy, and that makes it easy. Oh, okay. Whoops. Not tight enough. Okay. Now I'm just going to open this. Push my ribbon back a little. And there is my bag. Beautiful. Okay, thanks for putting up with my gymnastics, and order these muslin bags. We're going to use them a lot. They're so handy for gifts and party favors, whatever you want to use them for. So I'll be back. Thanks for stopping by.